Hey everyone, it's Flakfire. Battlefield has a slew of available weapons and has added quite a few since launch. However, there are several that have seemingly slipped away into the ether, never to be heard from again, and I think that's a real problem. For this video, let's talk about all the weapons we've seen in-game or in promotional material that we've yet to see in Battlefield 5's multiplayer, and it turns out there's more than a handful. To be clear on this, I'm not talking about data mined info, but stuff DICE have actually revealed themselves. Some of the most noticeable weapons missing from PvP include those we've seen in the game's single-player campaign. One of the biggest offenders is, of course, the Shosha LMG. The weapon actually appears in both Battlefield 5's single-player campaign and the Combined Arms game mode. A veteran of World War I, the Shosha appeared in Battlefield 1, where its steady, hard-hitting performance made it a favorite among players. Other weapons that haven't made the jump from campaign to multiplayer include an entire collection of suppressed guns. The suppressed Kar 98 can be found in several war stories, while players can also find the suppressed Sten in Tir Allure and a suppressed version of the Finnish Suomi submachine gun in Nordlees. Similarly, players can also use a suppressed version of the venerable M1911 in the first mission. It's a bit surprising that we haven't seen these suppressed weapons in Battlefield 5's multiplayer. DICE already added the suppressed Delisle carbine, which provides precedent for adding more of them. As for gadgets, there's a pretty neat one we can actually use on the Under No Flag campaign. It's the German Haftholadung magnetic shaped charge. This anti-tank weapon sticks to the side of vehicles and detonates. Interestingly, it was the impetus for Zimmerit, the anti-magnetic coating developed by the Germans and something that appears as a specialization for some Axis vehicles in the game. There's also the Fliegerfaust gadget, which, if you've been paying attention, has been lurking in the background of the armory screen for months. The anti-aircraft weapon fires several unguided rockets in an effort to down enemy planes, but it's never been spotted anywhere else in the game. Meanwhile, would you believe that there's a weapon featured prominently in Battlefield 5's reveal trailer, but we've never really seen it in-game? The reveal trailer released all the way back in May 2018, and there's still no sign of the hulking German Panzerschreck 16 months later. It does technically appear during the prologue, but you can barely see it, let alone use it. Similarly, the Shogren Inertial Shotgun was featured in Battlefield 5's company trailer, but has since gone AWOL. Another carryover from Battlefield 1, the weapon was a skill cannon, and it'd be great to see it in Battlefield 5. The British Wellgun was also spotted in a trailer months ago. This weapon was designed as a successor to the Sten for commando operations, and DICE even released promotional images for the gun on ArtStation before abruptly pulling them. Hopefully that latter bit of information means it's coming soon and the devs slipped up, letting the cat out of the bag just a tad too early. Another suppressed weapon, the bolt-action Wellrod pistol, was spotted on a character outfit in Battlefield 5's Firestorm trailer and has now been spotted in the trailer for Tides of War Chapter 4, but it is yet to arrive for players. If you really want to nitpick some more stuff that we've seen but haven't had a chance to play with in multiplayer, look no further than the Sherman tanks in Battlefield 5's prologue and the Rexha Bishop artillery on Arras. Now, the weapons I just talked about were some of the most egregious examples of the game's forgotten weapons, but there have been even more teased without any kind of clear release date. The Madsen light machine gun was teased in the Chapter 4 trailer, alongside the M2 carbine, Ithaca Model 37 shotgun, a suppressed Walther PPK, and the M1 bazooka. The M1 Garand and Type 99 Arisaka were also revealed during a tease for Chapter 5 at the end of that trailer. Meanwhile, the Browning automatic rifle was highlighted during EA Play. Now, I'm all for getting hyped about content in Battlefield 5, but at some point the question needs to be asked if some of this is bordering on deceptive marketing. The Panzerschreck is the most problematic example. The weapon was presented to players in promotional material and portrayed as a weapon usable in multiplayer. Yet the game launched without it, and you still can't use it 16 months later. The same could be said for the Shogren, which also appeared in a trailer but remains out of reach. At least the Wellgun and the Wellrod appear to be slated as rewards soon. When you tally up the numbers, there are 15 weapons that have been publicly teased in one form or another, plus 4 gadgets that aren't currently in the game. Even if you exclude those teased in Chapter 4's trailer, which I think is fair, there are 7 weapons and 3 gadgets that could be added to Battlefield 5 to make it a more engaging experience. And I know there's probably a good bit of work that would need to go into making them available, like third-person animations, for instance, but I want to encourage DICE to make the most of their efforts so far and roll out some of these weapons in multiplayer, especially given the live service drip-feed criticisms as of late. I am curious what you think about the issue, however. Should DICE simply bury the weapons, leaving them in development hell, or resign to single-player? Or should they bring them into multiplayer? Tell me your thoughts in the comments, and tell me which weapon you want to see the most. If you enjoyed this video, leave a like, share, and subscribe. To get updates on the latest Battlefield news, tap the bell to enable notifications. You'll also find the latest news and memes on my social media, which you can check out with the links in the video description. As always, thanks for watching.